Sleep is an essential biological process, and although it may seem like a state of inactivity, it involves highly organized changes in brain activity that follow predictable patterns throughout the night. These patterns are best observed using polysomnography, which combines electroencephalography to measure brain activity, electromyography to measure muscle tone, and electrooculography to measure eye movements. Using the results from these types of recordings, researchers have divided sleep into two major types: non-rapid eye movement sleep and rapid eye movement sleep, or REM sleep. Non-REM sleep can be subdivided into three stages. Stage 1 involves the transition from wakefulness to sleep. When someone is awake, an electroencephalogram, or EEG, will typically record high-frequency, low-amplitude brain waves. When someone begins to fall asleep, they enter stage 1, during which an EEG records low-amplitude waves of mixed frequencies. People are typically easily awakened from stage 1 sleep, and it is a relatively short stage of sleep overall. Stage 2 sleep is characterized by the presence of phenomena on an EEG known as sleep spindles and K-complexes. Sleep spindles are trains of high-frequency waves. A K-complex involves a biphasic wave that stands out from the rest of the EEG. Stage 3 sleep is also known as slow-wave sleep, or deep sleep. In stage 3, delta waves, which are low-frequency, high-amplitude waves, make up a significant proportion of brain activity. REM sleep differs in several key ways from non-REM sleep. The EEG during REM sleep resembles wakefulness, but muscle tone is profoundly reduced due to the inhibition of motor neurons by brainstem circuits. This inhibition of motor neurons prevents us from acting out our dreams, which are typically most vivid during REM sleep. Of course, REM sleep is also associated with the rapid eye movements that occur in this stage. Throughout the night, a person cycles through these stages of sleep usually around 4 or 5 times, with each cycle lasting about 90 to 110 minutes. The transition between sleep and wakefulness is controlled by a balance of arousal-promoting and sleep-promoting systems in the brain. Wakefulness is supported by widespread ascending arousal networks, which include, but are not limited to, acetylcholine neurons in the pedunculopontine and lateral-dorsal tegmental nuclei, norepinephrine neurons in the locus coeruleus, serotonin neurons in the raphe nuclei, and histamine neurons in the tuberomammillary nucleus. The tuberomammillary nucleus is activated by neurons in the hypothalamus that release orexin, also known as hypocretin. Antihistamines inhibit the histamine neurons in the tuberomammillary nucleus, which is why they can cause drowsiness in some people. While these areas are thought to play a role in wakefulness, research suggests there are other regions and neurotransmitters, including glutamate, GABA, and others, that are crucially important, and understanding arousal-promoting areas in the brain is an area of active research. The transition to sleep is thought to be controlled to a large degree by the inhibition of these ascending arousal systems. For example, neurons in a nucleus of the hypothalamus called the ventrolateral preoptic nucleus, or VLPO, project to most parts of the ascending arousal system and release the inhibitory neurotransmitters GABA and GALAnin onto these wake-promoting regions. Neurons in regions like the VLPO are also inhibited by neurons in the arousal system, which creates an arrangement sometimes referred to as a flip-flop switch, where each system turns the other off when it is active. This allows for rapid transitions between sleep and waking states. The generation of non-REM and REM sleep also involves distinct patterns of neural activity. During non-REM sleep, neurons in the thalamus fire in a synchronized pattern with neurons in the cortex. It is thought that this activity might reduce the transmission of sensory signals, in effect disconnecting the cortex from the outside world. During REM sleep, however, certain neurons in the pons drive activation of the cortex, while others project to the medulla and spinal cord to inhibit motor neurons and cause the paralysis characteristic of REM sleep. While these systems help to regulate transitions between wake and sleep and vice versa, other homeostatic and circadian factors regulate when we feel tired or more alert. One important factor in producing the desire for sleep that increases the longer we stay awake, often called sleep pressure, is a neuromodulator called adenosine. During periods of wakefulness, the cells of the brain use ATP for energy, and in the process, ATP is converted to a byproduct called adenosine. Thus, the longer someone is awake, the more adenosine accumulates in the brain. Among its many actions in the brain, adenosine binds to inhibitory receptors that are found in wake-promoting areas of the brain, in the process causing sleepiness. Interestingly, caffeine blocks adenosine receptors, which is thought to be how it achieves its wake-promoting effects. Sleep timing is further regulated by circadian rhythms, which are 24-hour cycles that regulate a long list of physiological parameters. Circadian rhythms act both to counteract sleep pressure during the day and promote sleep at night. Circadian rhythms are largely driven by neurons in a region of the hypothalamus called the suprachiasmatic nucleus. Neurons in the suprachiasmatic nucleus keep time, using rhythmic patterns of gene expression that repeat roughly every 24 hours. To ensure these circadian clocks are in tune with the outside world, the suprachiasmatic nucleus receives information from the retina about light in the environment from a pathway called the retinohypothalamic tract. Through this pathway, light serves as the primary external cue for synchronizing the suprachiasmatic nucleus with the environment. Activity in the suprachiasmatic nucleus ultimately regulates the timing of a long list of functions associated with sleep, including body temperature, hormone secretion, and blood pressure. Neurons in the suprachiasmatic nucleus also help to regulate the release of melatonin, a hormone that promotes sleep and is released primarily in darkness. Melatonin is produced in a region of the brain called the pineal gland, and also plays important roles in regulating circadian rhythms through actions like lowering body temperature and increasing tiredness close to bedtime. Sleep serves many important functions. Crucially, it is a way for our body to restore materials used during waking. It also acts as a period where our energy usage is reduced, typically at a time when expending energy would have been less beneficial for ancient humans due to our susceptibility to predators at night and poorer night vision for hunting and gathering. Sleep also seems to be important in the consolidation of new long-term memories of experiences and information someone was exposed to during the day. Another important function of sleep might be the clearance of metabolic waste from the brain through a network of cerebrospinal fluid-carrying channels called the glymphatic system. During sleep, the flow of cerebrospinal fluid through these channels increases, carrying waste products, such as the beta amyloid proteins linked to Alzheimer's disease, out of the brain. There are many different disorders of sleep. A full examination of them is beyond the scope of this video. Insomnia, which involves difficulty falling asleep or staying asleep, affects a relatively large proportion of people at some point in their lives. Sleep apnea, a disorder in which breathing during sleep can be frequently interrupted, is also a common sleep disorder. And other conditions like restless leg syndrome, narcolepsy, REM behavior disorder, and more also involve disruptions to the mechanisms that govern sleep.